संसार विस्तार आज ध्यान में शुरू करेंगे बिस्मिल्लाह रहमानीम। सो वी लर्न टुडे सूरह नसर एंड जस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड योर ब्रीफ बैकग्राउंड दिस सूरह वाज रिवील्ड एट द टाइम ऑफ लास्ट हज एंड इन दिस सूरह ए न्यूज हैज बीन गिवन to the Muslims and Prophet about the future, about good news that lot of people will enter into the fold of Islam, they will become Muslims. But at the time when the surah was revealed, the number of Muslims was not very large. So there were people during the second Hajj, the people who were in Makkah, they were not a large quantity who had become Muslims. Likewise in Medina. And in the cities around, people were still mushrik and kuffar. So at that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this good news to Prophet ﷺ that soon a time will come when a large group of people will start entering into Islam. So that's the background, and we will need that background to understand the surah, the words of the surah. So the surah starts with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Idha ja'a nasrullah. So let's look at the first word. It's very important to understand. The surah starts with the word Ida. In Arabic, there are two words, Id and Iza, which come very frequently in the Quran. Id and Iza. Both of these words have the meaning of when. But when is id used and when is idha used is a different situation. So in the Quran, whenever there is a mention of something that happened in the past, then the word id is used. So this is used for past. When the word idha is used, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning something for the future. The time that will come, then something will happen, or when something will happen. So this is for the future. This is important to understand this basic difference between id and idha. Okay? One is for the past, one is for the future. Okay? So now, keeping this in mind, let's just follow the words after that. So the first word here means when. Idha. Okay. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the word Ja'a Nasrullah. So let's look at those words. So the second word starts with these letters. Jim, Hamza, and Alif. Chaliyah. The original letters are Jim, Ya, and Hamza. Okay. The meaning of these three letters is to come. Okay. To come. Jim, Ya, and Hamza, if you look in the dictionary, the meaning will be to come. Okay. Now, the simplest grammar that we know is that if you have these three letters, Fa, An, and Lam, which means to do. And if I put one fataha on each of them, this becomes fa'ala. Fa'ala means he did. So by adding three fatahas on the three letters, the meaning is third person, he, and the past tense, he did. Okay? So if we apply this rule on these three letters, this will become Jim with a fatha, Ya with a fatha, and Hamza with a fatha. That will be the formation of these three letters. And the meaning will be, he came, third person past tense, or it came. In Arabic, he and it has the same. So this will mean he came, or it came. And that's the meaning of these three letters. Okay. Now, if you go back here and look at that, Ya is a letter here, which is a weak letter, and it has a kasra. Its sound is the sound of kasra. But here, this Ya has the sound of fataha. So this will go through a change, and this letter with a Ya with a fataha can be written as an alif like that. Sound of this Ya with a fatha is the sound of A, alif. So now the word becomes Ja'a. Ja'a means it came. Ja'a means it came. Okay. Now, by the rule of recitation in the tajweed, if you have an alif and there is a hamza after the alif in the Quran, when you're reading the Quran, if you see hamza and before hamza there is an alif, then you will have to pronounce this alif in the long mud. Okay? You have to, we know whenever we see, we pronounce with the long mud this thing. But why do we do that? The reason is that this hamza causes that alif to be pronounced long. Okay? So this hamza will cause this alif to pronounce long, and the pronunciation will be ja'a 4 to 6 times. Okay? In the original 3 letters, there is no mad. Okay? But when you have created the word, then by the rule, you will have to pronounce ja'a. Ja'a means it came or he came. Okay? Now, I also mentioned to you that this idha, the first word, is used for the future. Okay? So what it does, the word that comes after that, it came, is a past tense. This word idha will pull into the future tense. Because idha is very powerful. Okay? It means the meaning will be written when it came, but it will be understood when in the future it will come. The meaning of idha ja'a is when in the future something will come. It will come, and we'll see what that it is, but the meaning of the words will be when it will come. Okay? Literally, grammatically, the meaning is it came, but actual meaning would be when it comes or when it will come. Okay, so typically it is written as it comes, and the reason it comes is a past tense also. When you say when it comes, it will come. Okay, what will come? Let's look at the words after that. So the next 3 letters are these, Noon, Swad and Ra. Nasara, this means to help. Okay? And the noun from this is Nasrun. Nasrun means help. Nasrun means help. And the word after that is Allahu. Okay. Now, these are 2 independent words. If you want to combine them, then you put an off in between. Help of Allah. Okay. Help of Allah. And the rule is that when you combine 2 nouns, we have been seeing this every week, is that when you put an off in between, then you change these 2 dhammas into 1, and this into a kasra. Just like kitabun and Allahu became kitabu Allahi. Okay? So this will become Nasru, and this became Allahi. Okay? So when you read this together, it will be Nasrullahi. Nasrullahi means help of Allah. Those are the words in the Quran. Idha jaa Nasrullahi, when comes or when will come the help of Allah? There will be a time soon when Allah's help will come. Okay, so that's the meaning of Nasrullahi, help of Allah. Okay. Now the second word here after that is, it starts with these three letters, Fa, Ta, and Ha. The meaning of these three letters is to open. The name of Surah Fatiha, the opening chapter is from the same letters. Fataha means to open up something. Okay? And the noun that we create from this is Fathun. Fathun means something that has been opened. Or the opening. Okay? And it also means the victory, because when a city is falling, then it opens for the invaders. Okay? So Fathun also means victory. Okay? So that's the original word, Fathun, that means victory. Okay? Now, if you put Al before that, Al means the victory. The victory, and when you put Al before a noun, two dhammas change into one. So this will become Al-Fathu. Al-Fathu means the victory. And Wow before that means end. So when you read Wow, you do not pronounce this alif in between. Combine Wow with the lam. Wal Fathu. Okay. And the rule is that when you do not pronounce alif, whatever this harkat is on the alif, you change that to a small swab. And this small swad on alif is called Hamzatul Wasal, which means do not pronounce this alif. So now pronunciation will be Wal Fathu, end the victory. That's the word in the Quran. And came the help of Allah, and came the victory of Allah, from Allah. Okay, so this will be end the victory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving good news to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that soon there will come a time, idha, in the future, when Allah's help will come and the victory will come. Okay? So this is a good news being given to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the time of the Hajj, last Hajj. Okay? Then after that is the next word. And the word starts with Ra, Alif with a Hamza and Ya. This means to see. Ra, Alif and Ya, these three letters when they are written in this order, it means to see something. Okay? Now, going back to the basic rules of the grammar here, if you have these three letters, Fa'ala, and you put a Ta at the end, Fata, it will be pronounced Fa'alta. Fa'alta means you did something in the past tense, and this is in the table I gave you also today. فعلتا you did. This ta brings the meaning of you, one person you, and the past tense. So فعلتا you did something in the past. Okay. So if I apply this rule here, this will become رأيتَ. Let's put a ta at the end. And رأيتَ will mean you saw. Okay, so this will become رأيتَ. رأيتَ means you saw. Ra'aita means you saw. No, we have a surah Ra'aita al-Lazi. Okay, that Ra'aita is the same as this one. So the meaning will be Waw means and, Ra'aita, and you saw. Okay, but this Ida is very powerful. It will have the effect on this ayat also. The meaning will be and you will see. It will pull into the future, okay? Just like it did with the Ja'a, it will do the same to the next because the statement is not complete. Even though we have a sign of ayat here, but this Waw means statement is not finished. You are talking two things one after another, okay? So, Ida is also going to apply here, and you will see. Even though meaning is you saw, but when the victory comes or victory will come and the help will come, you will see. Okay? And then we can write down that. And in English, if I write you see, that means you will see. What will you see? Okay. So the word is Alif, Noon and Seen. These are the root letters. And In Sun is the noun. In Sun means a person. Like Insan. In Sun means one man or one person. Okay. And Nasun is the plural. Nasun means people. So Nasun is the plural of Insun, that means people. Okay. And when you put Al before that, this means the people. Al and Al changes last letter to Dhammas into one. So it will become Al Nasu, the pupil. Al Nasu, the pupil. And in the Tajweed, when there is a Noon and Lam together, then you do not pronounce the Lam. It's a Shamsi letter, so pronounce An Nasu. Pronounce Noon twice. Okay. So the word is An Nasu, the pupil. Okay. An Nasu. So the word has become now An Nasu, the pupil. Now, as I said, the Nasu and the Nasun, this is a noun, okay? And one of the rules that keeps coming is that if you have a verb and you have a noun after that, what is a verb? Ra'aita is a verb and noun is after that. So there is a combination of these two change the last letter of this thing here with the Fatha. So the word will become annasa. Okay, and that's the word in the Quran. And when you read with ra'ayta, you will pronounce ra'aytan nasa. Okay. So the rule is that, and these are very simple, very small rules, and they keep repeating in the Quran. Okay, so these are the two words. Khalaqa. Okay. Khalaqa means he created. Okay. It's like fa'ala, he did. Khalaqa, he created. Okay. So the meaning is that he created. Then the other word, take anything, for example, al-nasu or al-insan, for example. This is the ayat in the Quran also. Al-insan. Al-insan means the man or the mankind. Okay, so one of them is a verb here, khalaqa, something was done in the past. Khalaqa, something did something in the past, is a verb in the grammar. Okay. The other word is al-insano, or you can put any other noun there. Okay. Al-insano means the man, the person. Okay. Always the noun will have one dhamma at the end if al is there. The actual word is insanun. When you put al, it becomes al insanu. So always you will notice that this will be a dhamma there. Okay? Just like annasu has a dhamma at the end. Al fathu has a dhamma at the end. So all the nouns start with two dhammas. You put al, it becomes one dhamma. Okay? Now, if that noun comes after the verb, this is a small sentence now. Khalaqa, he created the man. So when you combine these two together, then this dhamma here, last letter, changes into a fatha. Okay? So this becomes insana. Always you will say in the Quran that you start with the dhamma. If the verb is there before that, it will become the maf'ul of that word. And maf'ul has this signature of a fatha on it. So that's a rule. It will keep coming in the Quran after every few ayahs or in almost every. Okay. So ra'aita is a verb. An-nasu is a noun. When you combine these together, you saw the mankind, you saw the people. Okay, by the combination, nasu will become nasa. So whenever you see something is happening and somebody is happening on somebody, then last letter will change. Okay, so you see the people. Okay, when the help of Allah comes, you see the people. So you will see what people will be doing when Allah's help comes. Okay, what are they going to be doing? The next word. Okay, so the word starts with these three letters, Dal, Kha, and Ram. Dakhala means to enter. These are the words, you know, they are commonly known. If you speak them a lot. Dakhala means to enter. Okay. If I put a ya in the beginning and pronounce as yadkhulu, and ya brings the present tense for third person. We have done this, but just to remind you, when you put a ya in the beginning, here it becomes yaf'alu. It means he does. Ya means third person and the present tense. So this will become he enters. He enters. Okay. And Vuna is a for the plural. Muslim, Muslimun or Muslimuna. When you put Vuna at the end, it becomes a plural. So Yadkhuluna will become they enter. So this becomes they enter. Okay. In Arabic, present tense and future tense have the same words. So this can be translated they enter or they will enter. So, but the word before that is pupil. So you don't have to put they in there. You will translate pupil enter or pupil will enter. Yadkhuluna, they enter, the pupil enter or will be entering because we are talking about the future. So, رَعَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ you will see the people entering. In English, you can say entering means they will enter. Okay? So, this will be entering. So, when Allah's help comes, this is what will be happening. And victory comes, then people are going to enter somewhere. People will be entering. Okay? Where would they enter now? The next few words are going to tell that. Okay? Okay, so now let's start with these three letters. Dal, Ya, and Noon. These three letters have multiple meanings, okay? But the noun that we will use here is Dinun. Combine these three letters and the noun will be Dinun. Okay, because all the nouns should have the two dhammas at the end. Dinun, like Fathun, Nasrun. Okay? What is the meaning of this word? Dinun means way of life. Okay? Or you can say lifestyle. The way of life people live is their lifestyle. Okay? So that's the actual meaning of Dinun or Deen. If you stop, you will say Deen. But the actual word is Dinun. Dinun means lifestyle. Way of life. The way people should live is their lifestyle. So that's the meaning of Dinun. Okay? Now, just to clear a little concept here, that in Arabic, there is a word, these three letters, Zal, Ha, and Ba, Zahaba. Zahaba means to go away. Zahaba is someone went away, someone goes away. Zahaba. Okay? The word that is created from these three letters, one is Madhabun. Madhabun, or we start with a Madhab. Okay? The meaning of this word is religion. English word. The meaning of the English word is religion. Okay? Nowhere in the Quran the word madhab comes. Okay? Wherever you will see the word for Islam is deen. Innad deena indallahi al-islam. The deen or the way of life with Allah is al-islam. Okay? So madhhab is not deen. What is madhhab? Okay? Madhhab is this. You take the deen of Allah. Okay? And someone took a piece of that and walked away. Go away. Okay? So someone took a portion or his own interpretation and walked away. He became, or the followers of that became the madhab, became Hanafi. Then somebody else came and did their own interpretation. And he walked away with that interpretation. That became another madhab. That became Shafi'i. And then Hanbali and the Maliki and the Shia and this and that. Okay? Those are madhabs. Islam is not madhab. Those are the divisions of the Islam. The interpretation of the Islam at the lower level. Okay? So those are madhahib or madhab. So when you see the word deen in the Quran, do not translate as religion. Okay. Islam is not a religion. Madhab is a religion, which are the divisions of Islam. It is not a good thing. Okay. So deen means way of life, the way of life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to live. That is deen. Okay? So then the next word is Allahu. And when you combine these by putting an off in between, it becomes you're talking about combining it. Okay. Yeah. So you do the same thing. So you remove this and make one. And you remove this and make a kasra. So it became Deenullahi. Deenullahi, just like the rules we keep following. Way of life Allah wants us to live. That is called Deenullahi. Okay? The lifestyle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to live is called Deenullahi. Okay? And you have one dhamma here, but the word before that is a fi. Fi is a harf-e jar, and what harf-e jar does, that it changes this dhamma to a kasra. So Deeno becomes Deeni. So now the word is Deenillahi, fi Deenillahi, in the way of living that Allah wants. So that's the meaning of fi Deenillahi. You will see people entering into the Deen of Allah. When the victory comes, you will see people entering into the Deen of Allah, which is Al-Islam, because Quran says, Inna Deena Indallahi Al-Islam. Indeed, the deen with Allah is al-Islam. So people will be entering into al-Islam. Okay? Into the deen of Allah. In the deen of Allah. Okay? Feeling sin, yeah, right here. Feeling sin. And fee will change deeno to deeni. Okay? So in the deen of Allah. And the other word, fa wao jim, faujun means group. Fauj is an army or a group of people. And its plural is a fajun. afwajun means groups. Okay. And also we just learned another rule that when this is a noun and yadkhuluna is a verb. So when the noun comes after the verb, then this dhamma changes into a fatha. So there are two dhammas, they will become two fathas. Okay. So the word will become afwajan. Okay. And whenever you have two fathas, you write an extra alif with that. Many armies, groups after many groups. Group is a group is a group of already a plural, not plural, but it's a combination of.
First jama hai plural,
aur
ye
afajin
jo hai ye
jama aur jama. Jama aur jama kaise? Yehi kaise? Fauj dar fauj. Army of army after army, groups after group. Ye maane afajin. So you will see people entering into Islam in large number of groups, one group after another. So very soon, within 50 to 100 years, the whole Arabia and all the area around Hijaz became Muslim. Okay, so that was the news that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Prophet ﷺ, that soon victory will come and you will see large number of people will become enter into the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is the fulfillment of the good news that people will enter, and that same thing happened. Nations, tribes, at one time became Muslim afterwards. So that is the entering into the deen of Allah in groups. So this will be in groups. Okay. So with that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ. Okay? So the next word starts with these three letters, Seen, Ba, and Ha. This means to float or swim. Sabaha means to float, something is floating or something is swimming. Okay? If I take these and put a shadda on the middle letter, become sabbaha. It has a different meaning. This means to glorify. Root letters are same, three letters, but when you put a shadda, it becomes a different group of words. Fa'ala, sabbaha, this means to glorify. And when you write in this combination, sabbih, sabbih, this is in a command, an order. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving a command, he is ordering. Okay, what is he ordering? Glorify. Tasbih karna. Do tasbih of Allah. Glorify him. Mention his greatness. Okay. Glorification is the greatness of something. Okay. Glorify. And fa means then. The fa in the beginning. The word is sub fa and sub bi. Then glorify or so glorify. So now, how to glorify? Okay. It means you are mentioning someone is great. You have to say, why is he great? Or what is that greatness is bringing? So those are the next few words. Looks at those one. Okay, first of all, these three letters, Ha, Meem, and Dal, this means to praise. Hamada, alhamdun, alhamdu, that is praising someone. Being thankful to someone, admiring someone, that's hamdun. Okay, so the noun is Hamdun. Hamdun means praise.
So Fasabbi means glorify.
That's order, that's command.
You have then.
Fa means then.
Fa, okay.
Fa means then or so. So here Allah is giving Prophet ﷺ a good news, and then after the good news saying, be thankful, glorify Allah, okay? Be thankful Allah, to Allah subhanahu, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, okay? So that is fa, then, or so, sabbih, glorify, mention the glory of Allah, talk about the greatness of Allah, okay? So the word is hamdun, okay? And then, there is another word, Rabbun. Rabbun means Lord. Rabbun means Lord. Okay? And then there is the word Ka. Ka means you, one person. Singular. Ka means you. One person. Rabbun, Lord, Ka, you. Okay? So put him off there. Between these two words, Rabbun and Ka. The rule is that when you put off, then Rabbun will change to one Fataha. Kitabu, so this will become Rabbu. Okay? And Ka is a pronoun, so nothing changes in Ka. So word become Rabbu Ka. Rabbu Ka means your Lord. Rabbu Ka means Lord of you or your Lord. Same thing, I'm saying Lord of you. Lord of you is same as saying your Lord. So the word is Rabbu Ka. Okay? Now, so you have a word Rabbu Ka and you have a word Hamdun. Okay? So if I put an off here, then the English will become praise of your Lord. Praise of Lord of you or praise of your Lord. Okay, so now I put an off between these two words here. So the rule will be, this will become one dhamma and this will become kasra. Okay, kitabullahi, just like the rule of kitabullahi here between these two. So it will become hamdu rabbika. Hamdu rabbi. Praise of your Lord. Okay. Glorify the praise of your Lord. Talk about the, do the tasbih of the hamd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Two things. Do the tasbih. Sabbih means glorify. You can say do a tasbih. Okay. Do tasbih what? The hamd of Allah. Okay. So tasbih, if you're counting tasbih, for example, then says Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. Okay, that's the hamd of Allah. Okay, so one more thing will happen is that be means off or with. Okay, be is a harf jar, and the rule of harf jar is that it looks at the next word. And the next word is hamdu. It will change hamdu to a hamdi. Okay. Very standard rules. Once we have been repeating these. They keep coming. So once, you get familiar with these things, then it will be easy to even read the Quran correctly. Okay. Because you know what should be the word after. So this word, be hamdi rabbika. Those are the words in the Quran. Be is there, हम दी इज देयर, रब्बी इज देयर, का इज देयर. सो ग्लोरीफाई द प्रेज ऑफ योर लॉर्ड. गो ऑन विद प्रेज ऑफ योर लॉर्ड. Let's look at the next few words here. This next word starts with these three letters, Gha, Fa, and Ra. Gha, Fa, Ra. Okay. Ghafara means to forgive. When we say Allah is Ghafoor Rahim, He is the one who forgives. So Ghafara means to forgive. Now, if in front of these three letters, one of the rules is that there are three letters which are called Alif, Sin, and Ta. Ista. If I put these three letters in front of these three letters, it will become Istaghfara. And there are many words in the language which starts with ista, istata'at, istamal, no, istar there. Okay, what is the meaning that ist brings? Ist brings the meaning of asking. Okay, so this will be ask forgiveness. The meaning that comes with the ist is asking. So ghafara is used for Allah. He forgives. Istaghfara we use for ourselves. We ask forgiveness. Okay? So this word goes with Allah. This word goes with us. We ask forgiveness. Allah forgives. So when you say ghafoor, it's for Allah. When we say istaghfar, it's for us. Istaghfar means we ask for forgiveness. And we say, ultimately, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. What are we saying? We are saying, we ask, we are asking Allah for forgiveness. Okay, so that is the meaning of istaghfara. Okay? And if I write down it this way, together, istaghfir. Istaghfir is a command, is an order, just like sabbih is a command. And we will learn more in the detail. Notice that in the word sabbih, when we learn here, the last letter had a sukoon. Sabbaha was the word, but we say sabbih. So what did sabbih do? The last letter with a sukoon brought a command. So here, if I put the same thing, last letter on this Ra, it made a command. Command is ask forgiveness. It's the command, it's the order. If I'm telling you, ask forgiveness, I'm ordering you to do something, right? So what I'm saying, istaghfir means ask forgiveness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, glorify Allah with Hamd and ask for His forgiveness. Okay? Now, there are two words, Waw before that and Hu after that. Okay. So, Waw means end, and when you read together, you do not pronounce the Salif. So, you combine Waw with Seen. So it becomes was. Was. And when you do not pronounce, then you put a little swad on this alif. Hamzatul wasl, which means do not pronounce alif. Pronounce was. And that's how it is there in the Quran. Was. Originally, the word is is. But when you put waw, then alif is not pronounced. So it becomes was. Vastagfir. Okay? Who means him? Ask him for forgiveness. Who is him pointing to? Allah. Ask Allah to forgive. Vastagfir who? Okay? Ask him to forgive. So command is, O Prophet, ask Allah, ask him for forgiveness. Or when you are reading the Quran, you are asking Allah for forgiveness. Okay? So that is the meaning of wastaghfirhu. It's very important to pronounce every letter, every word, otherwise the meaning will change. You have to pronounce who correctly, otherwise you don't know who you are asking the forgiveness. Okay? You have to pronounce the vowel correctly and with the seed. Wastaghfir. You have to pronounce fir very clearly. Sukoon, otherwise the meaning will become something else. That last sukoon is the one that's meaning this on the ra, it's bringing the meaning of ordering you something. Okay? Imagine that here if you did not pronounce fa'ala, you pronounce fa'al. The meaning will be something else. Okay? So it's important that we pronounce exactly with the same harakats, same letters, otherwise the meanings will change. They are very close to each other. So you have to say wastaghfir. Okay? You have to say fasabbih. Ha should have a sound of jazm or sukoon. Fasabbih. It will be a command. Otherwise you say fasabbaha or something else, totally different meaning. Fasabbih is the order. So order comes with the last letter has a sukoon on it. Okay? Wastaghfir. The last letter has a sukoon on it. Even though who is after that, but you have to pronounce this clearly. Okay? So the meaning is that ask forgiveness and ask forgiveness of him. Okay? Now let's quickly finish the last few words here. Innahu is made of two parts. Inna and who. Inna means surely. And who means he. Surely he. And he is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kana is made of three letters, Kaf, Waw, and Noon. This means to be. And this will come many times in the future when we go into the details. Kana means to be. And Kaf, Waw, Noon. And Kana means he was. And when it's used for Allah, he is. And indeed or surely he is, and we'll go into the details later on, but right now Kana means is, and surely he is. Okay, and the last word is Ta, Waw, and Ba, Tauba. And this is a very very detailed word, but it has multiple meanings. One of the meaning is to return. But the generally meaning is to do tawbah, okay, is to ask forgiveness. One of the meanings is to ask to be forgiven, tawbah, okay. It actually means turning back to Allah. Tawbah means to turn back to Allah, okay. And the word tawwaba is used for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tawwabun. Okay. So when we use the word tawbah for us, which means we are asking Allah to forgive. When we say Tawbah, we ask Allah to forgive our mistakes. But when this word is used for Allah, it means He is forgiving. He is returning to you with repentance, accepting the repentance. Okay, Tawbah. And Tawwab is the one who does the same thing again and again and again. It's say repeat. So Allah forgives again and again and again and again. Okay, we make tawbah, He forgives. Then we do something else, then we make tawbah, then He forgives. Then we do something wrong, then we make tawbah, He forgives. So that is the meaning of tawbah. Tawab is the one who will keep forgiving. Okay? So he is ever forgiving. Ever means always, 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 always. Okay? So that's the attribute or sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these words will come again in the other surahs and we'll go into more details. But right now the words which are created at this scale, that have a repetition in them. Qahhar, Jabbar, Tawwab, those words that are created at this rule, they have a repetition in them. So inshallah we'll stop here. Okay. We have